I'm Susan from Tarjac. You may know us as the source for the best camo for your guns and bows, but we do so much more. Our custom work with automotive parts can transform any vehicle, our ATVs, sleds, four-wheelers, motorcycles. We've received national recognition for our work with Orange County Choppers, and we are most proud of our partnership with the Future Servicemen by providing customized helmets for the Army-Navy game. From the national stage to your favorite hunting ground, it's Tarjac.
Hello and welcome to the CNY Business Connection. I'm Jason Weinstein. Coming up in this week's show, the do's and don'ts of internet marketing for your small business. Plus, the latest in Business Connection classifieds. We'll look at some local job postings, but we'll begin with the latest in business news from around the area.
Realtors in New York State sold nearly 5% fewer previously owned homes in July than in June as the housing recovery continues to be tepid. But the latest month's figure was more than 16% higher than July of 2010. The median sales price for homes sold in the state in July was $225,000, up from $220,000 in both June 2011 and July 2010. This according to the New York State Association of Realtors. Home sales data in central New York was mixed. In Onondaga County, realtors sold 384 homes in July, down 4% from June, but up 23% from the 313 homes a year ago. In Oneida County, 119 homes were sold in July, up 12% from June, but down 15% from July of 2010. And in Broome County, realtors sold 106 homes in July, down 9% from June, but up 18% from a year ago. The Marcellus Shale Formation holds even greater treasure than previously believed, according to a new study by the U.S. Geological Survey. The study shows a huge amount of recoverable natural gas and liquids in the deposit. The estimates are 84 trillion cubic feet of gas. Previous surveys estimated the reserve at just 2 trillion cubic feet. Pennsylvania is already tapping into the shale. Hydrofracking to extract the natural gas is on hold in New York while the state draws up regulations for the industry. Following the first meeting of the state hydrofracking panel, State Senator Tom Libous, a member of the panel, gave an update. The group is in charge of drawing up safety regulations and convened for the first time recently. The panel was created by Governor Cuomo in July. Libous believes that hydrofracking can be safe and beneficial to the local economy. He also says the creation of the panel shows that the governor is thinking the same way.
It tells me that the governor and DEC is serious about moving forward with environmentally safe drilling, and that's something I think we need to do. And you know, it's going to take time. It's not going to happen overnight, but I think we'll get there.
The panel will be meeting again in mid-September. DEC Commissioner Joseph Martins is asking for recommendations by early November. Two credit unions will be merging by December. Paragon Federal Credit Union will merge with Visions Federal Credit Union. The decision was made by the National Credit Union Administration. After the merger, the new credit union will have 29 branches in parts of New York, New Jersey, and Pennsylvania.
We hope you enjoyed that. Time now for a look at the latest Business Connection classified, some local job listings from around the area.
The Association for Visual Rehabilitation and Employment is looking for a manager of new business opportunities. This person would be responsible for identifying new AVRE products and services which have the potential to grow employment opportunities for people who are blind or visually impaired. Products and/or services identified must enhance both the mission and profitability of AVRE. The position has a focus on enhancing federal and state government business, but commercial opportunity development is also expected. Some business travel will be necessary to perform the essential functions of the position. Please send your resume to Kevin Berger's attention at AVRE, 174 Court Street, Binghamton, New York, 13901. You can fax your resume to Kevin at 607-771-8045 or email kberger@avreus.org.
As business grows, AVRE continues to create good jobs for legally blind individuals in various manufacturing, assembly, and packaging departments. These positions range from entry-level assembly and manufacturing to machine operators. AVRE offers competitive wages and benefits. Interested legally blind individuals should contact Kevin Berger, Accounting and Human Resources Manager, at 607-724-2428 or email him at avreinfo@avreus.org. And for more information on those listings, you can follow us on Twitter at BizConnectTV or go online at BizConnectTV.com/jobs. When we come back, we'll have the do's and don'ts of internet marketing for your small business, plus the latest bit of business wisdom from someone who has lived it, thanks to our friends at Prendismo.com.
I'm Norm Poulton. I've published the Central New York Business Journal for 25 years. Our success is based on the fact that we know only one audience, owners and managers of businesses in Central New York. We publish stories for them, we don't offer sound bites, and we always source our information. Maybe technology's changed since I started publishing 25 years ago, but not our mission. You can always rely on the Central New York Business Journal providing your business news.
Make your company's job opportunities stand out and get seen. The Binghamton Business Connection and BizConnectTV.com have created the area's first video job posting service. Don't hope a few words of text will get you the local candidates you want. Get your opportunities seen on the Binghamton Business Connection TV show and BizConnectTV.com/jobs. For an inexpensive multimedia and visual way to showcase your job openings, call 239-0199, email bizconnecttv@gmail.com, and watch the Binghamton Business Connection on My8. Welcome back. When it comes to internet marketing for your small business, there are definite do's and definite don'ts to go over. Some of the really important points, here's Lynn Harrison from Sword Saint Studios.
To know what works and what doesn't work on the internet for marketing, how to present things on the website to get the effect that you want. Many people do not have a call to action on their website. They have a brochure website where they provide information about what they do, but they don't really ask their visitors to do anything, whether it's to visit their store, click here for more information, join this mailing list for a newsletter. You need to provide some call to action to your visitor to ask them, what would you like them to do? An example, a very important example, and it's touched to in a later point, is what's called an opt-in list, to basically collect the contact information of your visitors so that you can build a relationship with them. The biggest thing is to be shown to be providing value to the visitors. You know, if it's collecting information and they don't see a value to themselves to provide it, then there's no incentive. Most people, when they're purchasing anything, whether it's online or offline, it takes multiple exposures to information before they can make a decision. By collecting the contact information, typically the email address from a visitor, you can communicate with them, provide them additional value, build a rapport and a relationship with that customer, and they'll have a greater tendency to come to you to purchase your products. There are services out there. One of the ones that's been advertising heavily in this area lately is a company called Constant Contact. There's also several others out there that they provide a service that you can use on your website to manage email addresses so they don't violate the federal anti-spam regulation, what's called the Can-Spam Act. There is an important feature called search engine optimization. It's basically adding information to your website so that the search engines like Google, Bing, Yahoo, they know what you're offering. By providing that extra information, you will rank in their searches. So when someone searches for your keywords, what you're offering, you'll show up in the search results. Within a website, there are what's called meta tags. It's getting somewhat technical. One is a title, and you want your keywords to show up in the title. There's also a description. The keywords should also show up there. When someone does a search, what you see on the search results page is your title and that description. So you really want to convey it in a human readable form that will attract the people once they've found you in the search, as well as let the search engine know that, you know, this is what you're providing. Print media, you don't know how many people actually saw your ad. With the internet, thanks to Google, you can add what's called Google Analytics to any web page. And they will track statistics for you as to how many people visited that page each day, what part of the world they're visiting from, how long they spend on the web page, so that you can gauge the effectiveness of your marketing. Basically, you look at it and see if someone's going to a, let's say it's a sales page, where you're actually trying to sell a product, and you see that people are only spending, you know, 10, 15 seconds on the site and then clicking off, you know that there's something on that page that is turning visitors off. And you can start reworking the page one item at a time and then track the statistics until you're seeing the reaction that you're expecting.
Our thanks to Lynn for that. And time now for a bit of business wisdom from someone who has lived it, thanks to our friends at Prendismo.com, partnering with entrepreneurs for success.
If you want to be an entrepreneur, you have to get ready to be that. I mean, taking this class is a very important step in that process, but probably you need a little bit more than that. And one of the things that I recommend is working for a big company. Actually, the guys at SiteSpeed didn't follow this model, but I did. I went to work for Hughes and got a chance to learn about designing satellite communication payloads. Now, that's not something you're going to do at a little small startup unless you have a bit of experience. Big companies have incredible resources. You, as a relatively young person, can come into an organization as doing big things, and you can learn about those things or those products or those services. And you can learn how that company in that market conducts business. They usually have great educational resources, both going to school and internal programs. And it's a great way to learn about something. In fact, you could almost think about it like going to school. I mean, I also had a tremendous amount of fun while I was there. And then when we left to start our own company, we had an expertise about, in that particular case, it was about these very small satellite terminals, which are now very common today, but were unusual back then, and we knew a lot about them. So we got a lot of work right away consulting in that area, and then we started, as I mentioned, started to build on that. So we weren't so much of a product company to start with. But that experience working for Hughes was just very valuable. So it's not, so I don't know, I think it'd be a lot harder to start your own company coming right out of school. Not that it's impossible, but you really should learn something well first.
And that does it for this episode of the CNY Business Connection. Thank you very much for joining us. Until next time, I'm Jason Weinstein. Have a good one. Make your company's job opportunities stand out and get seen. The Binghamton Business Connection and BizConnectTV.com have created the area's first video job posting service. Don't hope a few words of text will get you the local candidates you want. Get your opportunities seen on the Binghamton Business Connection TV show and BizConnectTV.com/jobs. For an inexpensive multimedia and visual way to showcase your job openings, call 239-0199, email BizConnectTV@gmail.com, and watch the Binghamton Business Connection on My8.